Welcome to SAP TechEd Live here in Barcelona. I'm here with Sindhu. My name is Phil. I'll be your host for about the next 10 minutes, and we're going to deep dive a little bit into the person Sindhu in this SAP environment. So, to take things off as a quick, easy start, now that you've become a Starfleet officer, tell us a little bit about the buzz behind that. How did you get to that point? Where does all that inspiration come from?
Well, if you've seen the keynote, Phil, I think you totally agree to the fact that we were demonstrating technology with a purpose, right? And for me, that's also what I love about SAP, that it's really that we build technology just not for the sake of building technology, yeah. But we're really helping the world, the universe, the people really run better and live better. And I think that's what was the driving force when I heard, okay, what are the key themes that will go into this keynote? I was like, wow, that's cool, and I want to be part of this. And yeah, it all happened, and I think we had some excellent keynotes both in Vegas and Bangalore and today in Barcelona. Enjoyed it completely, and I think it was fantastic seeing all the women on stage too. I'm sure you would agree to that.
Yes, definitely.
And also a little bit of the reverse roles today, Bjorn Eining.
It had a nice twist, yeah.
It had a good twist. Yeah, so it was been fun all through, and in the process also got to learn a lot of new technologies as well, which is always something that keeps me going and gets me into the groove, you would say.
Cool. So it's been about a year now since we last had a closer interaction when we did the design thinking part in Waldorf. But I would love to deep dive a little bit further into your environment in SAP and mm-hmm. how you got there. So what inspired you to actually go into technology? Like, away from the executive Sindhu, the VP, more to how did you start? What inspired you? What was the first things where you said, oh, tech, that's my fun space. That's where I want to be.
Well, it started off, I grew up in Bangalore, actually. And growing up in Bangalore, it was pretty common those days that there were two professions that were cut out for you, right? And it was either you go into studying your medical profession or you go into engineering. And though medicine had a lot of purpose, absolutely, I thought technology was cooler. And that was kind of the beginning at that point in time. So I studied computer science. Mm-hmm. And since then, it's been a fun ride. And I'm glad I made that decision. And absolutely great to be in the technology space, especially today when we see so much of innovation happening. It's been a great experience so far, and I'm sure it's going to stay that way.
Okay, cool. So how long have you been now with SAP, and what has been sort of your journey in SAP to be where you are today?
I started off back in 99. Okay. Started off in SAP Labs in Bangalore, actually, in the CRM middleware space. And back in 2001 is when I moved to Germany, still with CRM middleware. So you kind of always been in the integration technology space to a great extent. And then moved, back in those times, we had SAP NetWeaver. I'm sure you remember
that. I remember those days. I remember Marketplace 1.0 and yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, and then it's evolved from there. And today, I lead up the product management for cloud platform integration and for IoT, and also for process orchestration. And this journey has been fascinating, not only because of, absolutely because of SAP, but it's also working with so many customers over the years and seeing them also transform themselves, their businesses, mm-hmm. helping them in that transition. Helping myself go through that transition. That's how I've came to where I am today.
Okay, so looking at that transformation, I mean, 99 to 2017, there's been so many flavors and variations of what SAP has gone through, from the product company, a huge marketing engine behind it, becoming the cloud enabler that they are today. What were sort of the things that sparked your interest the most, where you said, oh, this is a barrier here, I'm going to have to work really hard because it's a complete mind shift? And how did you
I think
enter
one of
that?
The things that changed, if you remember, was the whole shift into just building products to working with our customers, working with our mentors in this design thinking mode. Yeah. I think that's something that I personally find very fascinating, because that way you really build software what your customers need, right?
Yes.
And not what we believe should be built. And I think this was a major mind shift for us internally, and I think that keeps your spark alive, because you get to meet so many people, different personas, different mindsets, and it's always difficult to also build software that kind of adheres to all this diverse personas. So you have to be very clear in terms of who's your target person who you're working with, and that boils down to the whole design thinking. And I think SAP has also transformed itself as a company in terms of how we have embraced these principles, and today it's like regular practice, right? There's no product out there that's not following these practices. And I think that, and also the move into the cloud, and the fact that we are so open to partnerships, we work with the ecosystem so much more than before, I think all these are key things that have also transformed the company and how we work.
Okay, so shifting a little bit into your private life, how does the work that you do, how does that impact your private life? Is it very tech focused, and are you always connected, and are you geeky gadget person, or are you trying to have sort of that disconnect when you come home, enter home, and say, okay, now this is a safe zone?
No, I think a lot of people talk about work-life balance. Me personally, I think it's such an old school thing, right? Because for me, it's important that work and life and everything around it is fun, right? I'm a fun person, and all these aspects need to come together. And for me, as long as you're in the flow, and if you're able to go with the flow, it doesn't really matter if it's work or private life. And so, yeah, to answer your question, there's no kind of a clear, okay, this is now work, and this is now home, and these parts totally crisscross for me, and that I'm totally fine with that.
Okay, that's nice. So, when you look at the environment you're in, and you look at some of the challenges that you had to overcome in the years, where do you think were your biggest jumps that you had to take in terms of a mindset change or a personal challenge where you said, wow, that was really tough, but that made me really embrace what I'm doing?
Oh, lots of things. But I think one key thing as a woman in technology, right? It's sometimes you're always in a room filled with men, and you have to be able to get your point across, right? And that doesn't always have to translate into speaking, being the loudest in the room, not at all. On the contrary, it boils down to really knowing your stuff, being passionate about what you do, and to bring that into that room, and then kind of making sure that the folks in the room are also paying attention, right? Mm-hmm. And this, I think, is a challenge that most women face in technology. Mm-hmm. Let's be honest to ourselves. But I think I've navigated it pretty well. And SAP is also a great company which really encourages women in technology. So
yes,
we are seeing a fascinating mind shift here. You saw that on the keynote today, right?
Instance,
so
yep,
that was the best example,
I
think.
The ironing board was perfect.
Yeah, so challenges are part of the game.
Okay, so if you were to describe yourself, and I usually, when I do design thinking sessions, I always try to have people interact with me in terms of saying something private, something company related, and then giving me one or two words that describe themselves and quickly explaining why. What would be your one or two words that would describe you when you would you introduce yourself to a person?
I think being passionate about anything I do, even if you meet me 5 years down the line, I'm sure I'll be still very passionate about what I choose to do, right? And so being passionate is key for me, and having fun with what I do is also extremely key for me.
Okay, very, very cool. So thank you very much for that little glimpse at who you are and what's behind the executive that is driving force in SAP. Thanks much, and we'll hopefully have another interaction some further days down the road.
Absolutely.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you very
Bye.
Much.